All right, so let's take a look at the Esprit solid modeler. Okay, so right here, this is the toolbar for the solid modeler. Okay, now if you don't see it, you get access to solid modeler toolbar by going to create and solid modeler. Okay, so you have a few functions on here. The main two are extrude and revolve. Okay, so revolve is more for round parts, cylindrical bodies, and extrude can be any kind of other geometry, which also includes cylindrical bodies. And you also have editing functions. You could put radiuses and chamfers on parts. You could also do merge faces and split faces, okay? So anyways, first thing you need some kind of geometry, okay? So I'm gonna go here and draw a polygon. So I'm gonna say I have a 6-inch hex and I'm gonna place it in the middle of my part, okay? So I'm gonna hit escape to exit my polygon command. Now, if I just hit extrude, basically what happens, it says group geometry does not represent simple continuous curve, okay? That's because I didn't select any geometry. So first thing I want to do is I want to select the geometry, then hit extrude, okay? I'm gonna rotate my preview here. Okay, so what you're seeing in the green is actually a preview of the 3D model, okay? Now notice how it's going up. If I click reverse direction, it goes down, okay? Basically, I have it on n-type blind. Usually, you're gonna have it on blind. You can also do mid-plane, which basically extrudes 5 inches each way. You have up to face. I can click up to face. That's good for cutting or adding, basically building a model upon a model. And you have through all. Okay, that's great for cutting. Basically, taking geometry and cutting it through a 3D model. So I'm gonna start off with blind. Okay, so distance. Basically, that's 5 inches, okay? So if I had a 10-inch hex, I would do 10-inch. And if I hit tab, it updates to preview, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and keep it at, let's keep it at 4. So I clicked 4, type 4, and I'm gonna hit tab, it updates to preview. So if I hit okay, now I notice it turns gray, okay? That's because it's now the solid model. We're not looking at a preview. All right, so say that I have a hole going through this hex, okay? So basically what I would want to do to actually modify this 3D model or edit it is I could go over here and go to circle and I could place it in the center. I'm gonna make it this big. I'm gonna hit escape to exit my circle command. Now, if I select the circle right here, what I could do is I could go to extrude and what I do is take that circle and cut it. Now notice right here, I don't have the cut option available, okay? So what I want to do is go right here where it says active solid. I want to go to body one. Now, what it'll allow me to do is to take that circle I just drew up and cut it, okay? So if I just click cut, I'll now hit okay, and it'll cut that through, okay? Whatever distance I wanted to. Now in this case, I had it going all the way through. Okay, I'm gonna hit undo. Now, say I select the circle. Say I only want to cut 1 inch down, right? So what I can do is I can go to one right here, my distance, make that one. I still don't have cut available. That's because I have to select the active solid. So I'm gonna go to active solid, click body one, and I'm gonna go to cut. Now, if I hit OK, it now cuts 1 inch deep. Okay. So that's pretty much the extrude. I'm gonna hit undo. I could also select that circle and I get extrude up, okay? So what I can do is I can uncheck the reverse direction and click and basically extrude it up. Now, one problem with this is if you notice, I actually have two models right here. I have a model of the hex and I have the model of the circle, okay? I have two solids. Now, say for example, I want them to be the same solid, okay? Basically, what I could do is I could select the circle, go to extrude. I can still extrude it up 1 inch, but what I want to do is I want to select active solid and collect that body of the hex. Now, if I hit OK, now what you'll see is if I select the solid, it's all one solid, okay? Basically, the hex with this hub that extends up, okay? So that's pretty much the basics of the extrude tool. Then you also have revolve, okay? Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and delete all of this. Now, say that I want to draw a cylindrical body, okay? I'm gonna go ahead. I'm gonna say my OD is 4 inches. And my ID, oops. And my ID is, we'll say it's 2 inches, okay? We'll say that the part is, we'll say 2 inches long, okay? Go ahead and trim this up. Okay, so I have something that looks like this. We're going to say we have a cylindrical body that we want to create, okay? So basically, I'm going to take this rectangle. Now, same thing, if I just hit Revolve, it tells me the group geometry does not represent the simple continuous curve, okay? So basically what I want to do is I want to select this box right here, then hit Revolve, okay? Now I have an angle, okay? Say that I have it at 90 degrees, right? Now what I have to do is I have to select the axis. So this little peach value box right here, if I click in that and click on my axis line right here, what you'll see is you'll see something that looks like this. Okay. That's because it only revolved 90 degrees. Let's go ahead and undo that. Okay. So, say we want to make a complete cylindrical body. We want a cylinder, okay? So, I'm going to select this geometry. I'm going to go to revolve. I'm going to put this at 360 degrees. My axis is going to be right here. Okay. If I rotate my preview, I now see this. Okay. And this is pretty much the basics to the extrude revolve, the solid modeler. You also have stuff like radius and chamfer, right? So basically, if I click on chamfer, I can put 100,000 chamfer right here. So if I click this little peach spot right here and click the edge and hit OK, what you're gonna see is chamfer right there, right? And I can do the same thing. Say I want a radius, same thing. So if I click radius, this little window pops up, right? So basically, here, let's do a different one. All right, let's fill it. All right, so if I go to fill it, say I'm at 100,000th radius right there, right? So if I click the peach little value window and click the edge of my part, click OK, we're gonna hit OK. I now have a radius right here. So it's pretty much that simple. And I could do the same thing. I could do basically revolve a cut. I can draw. All right, so say for example, I have this geometry right here, right? Say that I draw a rectangle right here. So what I could do, if I hold my shift key down, I could select this rectangle I just drew up. And what I could do is I can go over here and go to revolve. Revolve 360 degrees. And I could revolve around my yellow line. Now, I can add upon the 3D model, the cylindrical body right here. So if I hit OK, I will see something like that. Now, just like the extrude function, basically, I have two models on top of each other. Not really what I want, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead, select this rectangle again. Let's go back to Revolve. Select the axis. It's gonna be this yellow line. And if I put it on body one, basically what it'll do is it'll add that to the current cylindrical model. So this is all one model, okay? Let's hit undo. Now say you want to cut a groove, okay? So if I selected this geometry and I wanted to cut an OD groove around this axis into the cylindrical body, what I do is I select the geometry, I go to revolve, select axis, this is my axis right here. My body one is right here, but if I hit cut, what you'll see is you'll see something like this. So now I have a groove going through. And if I want to, I can get rid of all this geometry and it doesn't affect my model. And that's pretty much it. It's pretty simple.